outright mockery of the U.S. military's inability to either capture or kill Suwadi Sadono. The guerrilla leader has appeared on the front lines of nearly every major, being sold over the internet and have become popular across the world. Even their wearers seem largely unsure whether or not irony is.
I mean, it seems like we went to war without declaring anything, and a war we're kind of losing. I don't know what's...
Bringing the smallpox vaccination death toll to 6. Still no word from government officials regarding...
Komodo Shipyard, Komodo, Indonesia. I wonder if that is where the Komodo dragons come from. Anyway, April 18th, 2006, 5:24 hours. Now, it's funny how it took 6 days for Third Echelon to break down exactly where Sadono's called school, but I suppose that's just the nature of the game. Infiltrate the submarine. Sadono's Pandora Tomorrow phone call is being forwarded through an encrypted relay in the communications system of a submarine docked in a supposedly abandoned shipyard. Infiltrate the submarine and access the communication system to further trace the call. Greetings, fellow. Thanks for coming back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow. In the last video, we went ahead and more or less just went to a refinery, a cocaine refinery, where established by Saudi Sadono in order to, you know, put a tap on his phone call and essentially figure out where he is holding his stock of, the smallpox, which can be pretty much just distributed all over the world at his signal. So, having done that, the trace has currently, for now, ended up in a submarine in the Komodo. I think Komodo is an island in Indonesia. I'm not really certain though. But so what we need to do is we need to go ahead and infiltrate the submarine to further trace that damn call. And I'm not going to spoil this for you, but yeah, let's see how this level goes.
You're just about in position.
Right. I see the abandoned, but where's the shipyard?
Underground. The dock was made for submersibles.
That's as much of a introduction that as we're going to get. I'm just quick saving here. I think we need to be careful. I'm not certain whether there are any traps in the area. There do not seem to be any, but we do still do need to be careful.
Movement! I need a ground check in my sector. Sure it's not another bird has? It's alright, I'll take a look.
So yeah, that very well could have been visual as well, that movement that these guys were talking about. And there is what I think is a sniper up there, so we best move carefully. Checking the traps again. I'm not certain if there were pheasants in the area, but if there are, then it would be best to move cautiously. I can hear birds in the background, but I don't know if they are part of the foliage or an actual part of the levels. I thought I saw something over there. So, I'm not certain whether that is a sniper or just an automated turret. It would seem to be the latter. I can hear the latter, but I think that thing in front of us is the former, an automated turret. Oh yes, the turret is right there. I'm surprised how it hasn't seen me yet. Very strange indeed. Now, if I remember correctly, we are supposed to go through here. So yeah, let me just go and save here. Somebody just spotted me, I don't know who it was or how they did it, but somebody just spotted me. Is there someone over there? Well, I don't know who it was that spotted me, but somebody showed that. Apparently, it was the damn sniper who did that, and that sniper rifle looks far more like a shotgun to me, if you ask me. Or perhaps it was this guy who was. At any rate, I'll just stay here, and Good saving again, just in case I get spotted again. Moving back into the shadows. Might just have been that guy, because the sniper doesn't really spot you as often. So I can't see anybody else above me, so must have probably been that guy then. He's now headed away, so let me go and try to make a run for it. Come on, jump up. I swear, the game looks so stunning in black and white sometimes. Best to move slowly because the wood is creaking, as is the nature of wood to creak. Again, this area is fine. I remember this level being one of the more difficult ones. Just making sure that there are no traps around in this area. Not that I can go through the front gate anyway, because I mean, it's completely lit, so we are probably going to have to rely on the back gate. Like going around the back, but that seems to be lit as well. I suppose maneuvering through the front is the best option. Yeah, that did not work. That did not work at all. Can I take this light out? I think I'm going to have to do that, because it does not seem to work apart from that.
That's weird.
Like, the sniper immediately spots you anytime. Yeah, I suppose that is as simple as a solution as can be. I'd never noticed that light before, and looks like I've just been driving myself crazy all this while. I'm pretty sure I spent the last 15 minutes trying to do this. I'll just wait for this guy to go before I attempt to climb that area, climb this wall. Yes, thank you, answer. I can't? Oh no! I thought I could totally climb that wall. Went through again. But I think I can. I think that's where I climbed through. Yeah, I thought you're supposed to be able to climb through it. Should be a good enough spot to save. Traps, none that I can see here, but that guy's just standing there, and that sort of gives me the heebie-jeebies. Still can't see any traps. It's that area. The one with the dog. Safe thus far, but I am pretty sure that there's a dog in there, and you just need to be a little cautious about how you approach this. Like, I do remember there being a dog somewhere around here. I think what we needed to do was go down there. Oh wait, that's the dog, isn't it? Yeah, right. That is the dog, yes. I don't think we can just waltz in through here, but let's try. What's the worst that could happen, right? You'll probably just have to reload. Look at us go! Sleeping person in there? I think this way we can just simply bypass the dog altogether. Because I think the dog is still in there and we just need to go trudge forward, trudge onwards. I wonder what this game would be like to play in, well. First person mode, and yeah, I will be covering that as well. Because I think this game does have a lot of potential for shootout. A lot of potential for shootouts. Now, what's sort of concerning is that guy's looking straight at me. And I think the doggy is right there. Not that it should matter, but yeah, you never know. Let's try this, I guess. Well, I don't think the guy can see me, because otherwise he would have probably reasoned along about somebody being here that's not supposed to be here. And I'm literally walking in front of him while being completely illuminated. Wait, where am I supposed to go? Wait, was I supposed to enter that building? Oh wait, here. Yeah. This side, yeah. Now, should I be? I think I should, because I can hear a mechanical turret in action. Although, I was wondering whether or not to use the bite, but I do not think it is necessary. Let me just go into shadows and save. Okay, there's a guy watching television over there. Who else? Anybody else? No, just one guy watching television. Ah, yes, the stage. Right. Super close to the end of this section we are. That guy probably comes along and he just sits at his computer. And that's fun. So I'll just take the night vision goggles off so that you guys can see how beautifully detailed the world in this level is. I'll just go ahead and save. Although probably not a good spot to quick save, but still. SWAT rules for the win. Diesel generator. I'll just wait for the gun to start moving the other way, and then I'll move. We should be clear of the gun now. Saved once again, but then I did like a very stupid mistake. I wonder what that guy's listening to. He's just not even listening to his radio, it's just making static. I think he just saw Fisher and he was like, nope, I don't want any part of this, and he just loped his way out. And that was that. And that's the trapdoor that we need to access, but look at this level design. Whew. Oh, come on, keep moving. Beautiful, if you ask me. Simply beautiful. I just want to check out whatever's in there. And seems to be a whole lot of nothing. I think we can jump down. Huh. Now, what I find really strange is how the night vision mode did not show me these lasers, when in fact, well, maybe they don't work on infrared, on the infrared frequency, maybe they're ultraviolet, who knows. But yeah, typically the night vision goggles are supposed to show them. At least that's the way it is in chaos theory. And I think that takes us to the next part of the level, which is... Oh no, I think we need to get into the... No, we're all here. I'm just gonna switch it off just because it makes me feel a little safer. And then I'm gonna come in. I wonder if I should take these lights out. Down, I suppose?
GPS shows you're a stone's throw from the control room. Walk softly and use that technician. If you raise the sub yourself, you're going to bring up a lot of Darah Dandoa, who won't be happy to see you.
You're underestimating my charm.
Excuse me, I'm still inside the lift. Thank you. I was hoping there would be like a section here that would give sort of a break, but apparently not. I wonder if I can just jump up and grab onto this pipe here, but I do not think that is possible. At any rate, I'm just gonna create a new savior. Again here.
Hey, who did that?
That was Fisher. Samuel Fisher. I think you've had the pleasure of having heard the name. Okay, I did not see that guy, but that was a... Even though it was not expected, that was a very smooth infiltration. I mean, I almost got caught there. I should have been caught there, but...
I was just sending an update back home. It'll still be there.
Well, I'm pretty sure where we have to go is towards the end there. And, yeah, I don't know if that guy's coming back in or not, but let's do it again. Anyway, assuming that that guy's not coming back in. And that's the technician we're after, I'm assuming. There's also like this shootout section to this entire thing. Well, I guess that guy does come back. But does he come here or not? No, we just will try it back out. Alright then. Time to grab this guy. And make him scream. Time to pull him into the shadows. Where it will be difficult for others to see us. Hopefully.
Hi. How's your English?
Super!
Super. I need you to raise that submarine.
Why?
Because hurting people ruins my sweet disposition.
Ah. Yes, yes, right away.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Please, don't hurt me.
Well, shit's gonna hit the fan soon anyway, so...
Karen, what's going on? We weren't supposed to surface for another 4 hours. Karen, are you there? Answer me if you're there. Otherwise, I'm pulling the alarm.
Tell him we're kosher.
What?
Tell him nothing's wrong.
Okay. There's no problem. I had a warning light flash on the ballast tanks. I'll put you back under as soon as they're fixed.
Copy that. Thanks.
Okay, that was smooth. Yeah, now we just need to wait for our car to go on so that we can actually place this car in the shadows instead of, you know, somewhere where there aren't as many shadows. Alright, that was nicely done. Now move on. Well, let's see here. I wonder if it's gonna be as easy to get out. I do not think it is. Primarily because that guy's still on. Well, maybe we can just go ahead and use a diversion here and make it lighter toward. But we'll have to get a little crafty with what we just have to do. Maybe we can start out with these lights here. Ah, darkness, just the way I like it.
I hear someone.
That didn't do shit. No idea how this is gonna go. This used to open that it goes smoothly. That guy didn't see me, so it must be okay. Thus far, at least. Of course, there isn't. What makes you think there would be? I suppose that's up. Should I? Yeah, might as well.
Hey, who did that?
I don't know who it was. Sure as hell wasn't me. I have no idea what you're talking about, sir. Ah yes, this is the second part, right? I wonder if the submarine is, the actual submarine itself is also part of this same campaign or the same level, but I guess we'll have to play out to find out. The next section is like a complete firefight section, but yeah, same. Okay, there's a guy right there. At least he has his back turned to us, so that's good. What just happened? I mean, why was there like a dramatic sound? Pretty sure, yeah, I can't exactly drop off from here. I wonder how am I supposed to get anywhere without severely injuring myself. Pull-ups for the win. Sam Fisher and his pull-ups. I think this would be the better thing to keep for now, with Sticky Shopper especially. Probably because of how... easy it would be to have incidents on board a ship like this. I think I should be safe here, as long as the other guy doesn't come here. Let's see. Edging my way to the light area. Yeah, it doesn't. I'm cool. We're cool. I should probably save here, because it's gonna get pretty messed up as soon as we step onto the next bit. Boy, this game is tough. No wonder Fisher is practically invisible with the places being this dark. So, I'm gonna try something here. So apparently there's a zipline under there which you can use to essentially just make your way across without having to use the pulley, but I do not know if that is the correct way to go. Now there's something lighting it all, and I would rather like to take it away. Of course they have removed the alarm limitations, so I just want to play this level through as stealthily as possible. So as soon as that thing starts moving, that's basically, you know, it's completely well lit and other people start looking at it as well. So that more or less, that's what I should have done. Should have saved the, yeah. So this is what I was looking for essentially. I mean, I never really realized this while playing the actual game, but it's very much a part of it, and yeah. As soon as that guy looks away.
Grim's daughter's got her hands on Komodo's security personnel protocols. Inside that submarine, you're going to be outmanned and outgunned.
That's everywhere I go.
No, just need to wait for that guy to essentially come here before I can access the submarine. Saving it, just for the sake of saving. Since we don't essentially know what's gonna happen to us. I mean, this entire area is quite dark, and that looks is absolutely stunning. So, yeah. The only problem is the area near the submarine, that's quite well lit, so we have to be a little careful on how we approach it. Somebody saw something, but too late now, boy. It's too late now. Oh, wait. Yeah, right. I was accessing the wrong patch there. Yeah, see, we have like another pair of set of ladders here to crawl down. Like, everything in the submarine is pretty tight quarters, so yeah. SISSIXS is whatever they told us to retrieve. Although I do recall this being like a much simpler level, much more straightforward level as compared to, well, the one from the Celta submarine infiltration mission. Yeah, so that guy's gonna go there and pose for a bit. And that should probably give us the amount of time required to make it to this tour. I'm just gonna save it. For I have not saved in a while, and this area seems fine. No need to rush through it. We have to descend a level lower. But yeah, as far as I do recall, this level does end in a shootout. Now how do we distract that guy is the question. So as it turns out, we don't exactly have the time to pick up the diversion gap.
What is that?
We need to be a little quick, like speed is an element here. Because if we take our time picking up the diversion cam and then go in, then this guy more or less catches on to us. And that is not good, that is not what we want. So I'll just go ahead and rush in here. Despite wherever it takes us. This is this is a good spot to save this bomb. Took me a few tries, but yeah, we got to it. If somebody comes here. Oh yeah, there's a guy coming. Yeah, that's he's gonna come all the way here. That's Saudi Sadono. Gotta just take him out right now. Pretty sure I can. No, that is not actually Saudi Sadono. I could like make a run for it behind this guy's back. And if this guy is gonna stay like this, I might as well, but for now I will just wait it out and see how it goes. I have to say, the thing about Pandora Tomorrow levels is their length. They're like pretty damn long. Let's make a break for it though. Because apparently this guy's gonna stay like that. But do we need to grab them so that we can... Ah, I see. Use the retinal scanner. Right. So we actually needed to grab that guy. And drag him all the way here. And I'm pretty sure that retinal scanner was only there, so that extra area is only there so that we can hide once something happens after we grab this guy. Go Indonesian guy. But then again, he is a part of a dangerous militia, so might as well be a little careful about that. Yes, this is where we knock him out then. I wonder what the satchel had. Data stick. I mean, it's been a while since I've had a data stick. Can I not? Yeah. Special intelligence satellite submarine information exchange system is an over the horizon targeting. Okay, over the horizon targeting is basically targets and tighter communication increase. System developed to complement low frequency links, unlike general service SISSIXS or SISSIXS, I don't know how you pronounce that. This system provides complete privacy to any number of users by utilizing unique ID numbers. All communications are transmitted by sport broadcast, allowing multiple subscribers to share satellite resources and SISSIXS network. Can spread itself over any number of satellites. Go to Troll Mano, Scored Podcast. She makes me laugh. I like it. I'm sorry. At this point, anyway. Expect the call. The last insurance policy is active. USBMC in place. USBMC in place? Excuse me? Sadono can add it to his roster of phone calls. Okay, now. They say USBMC in place. This is pretty... this is a pretty big thing. I mean, I don't exactly want to spoil this for you guys, but the villain in Chaos Theory also works for a US based BMC. And it may just be that that same guy is also working with Daradandor in Pandora Tomorrow. Because, I mean, the entire plot for Chaos Theory is slowly being built up in this game, and it might as well be that essentially these guys were hired by the other agency, the foreign agency that's the villain in Chaos Theory, without getting into spoilers, of course. But let's see. I won't save it, but I will go with it.
I'm gonna go down a cup of coffee. I'll be back in a few minutes.
Can you bring me a cup?
No.
You know the equipment's too sensitive for us to drink in here.
Allegedly, that is very much good. But what I can hear is a camera somewhere in the vicinity. And that is something that I do not like. Let me just create a safe here. Now, I have no idea if what I'm hearing is a camera or something else entirely, but I think this part of the map is ripped straight out of Submarine.
Great work, Fisher. What do we got, Grim?
Just need to find the terminal's ID number. There. Looks like we've got 5 subscribers. Satellite phones.
U.S. numbers?
Yeah. Echelon's linking them to a private military corporation. Something called Displace.
We'll run a cross-check on their recent contracts. 5 PMCs line up pretty nicely with our 5 POX boxes.
What's my part?
Amityville time. Get out. If we got the POX boxes, then there's nothing stopping us. The Joint Chiefs will want to move fast. Rendezvous with Cohen. It's about time you introduced yourself to Sadono. Yeah.
Okay, so I was trying to avoid taking the name there, you know, sort of not spoil the story in Chaos Theory, but these guys sort of more or less did it for us, so yeah, Displace. Displace might just be the culprit in this case. I mean, Displace. One of the villains used to work with Displace in that game. Oh, so this is, I think, where we came out from. Where we were supposed to go down, initially. Where I was trying to go down, at least. Now, here's the thing, as soon as we get up here, it's gonna be all of war. Like, complete all of war. I don't know why it hasn't triggered it, but yeah, it's about to trigger. Maybe smoke grenades, maybe sticky bombs. I have no idea. I'll try the smoke grenades first, but I'm gonna sure as hell save it. It's gonna get ugly. Like, real ugly. Should have stuck to the side, so should have hung off the ledge there. I'm right next to the guy, how could he not see me? So I'll just wait here and wait for that guy to come up. There's no real way to sneak past him. Not from what I gather anyway. I mean, I can stick to the side and try to walk along. He does not seem to mind that, but I'm pretty certain that I'm gonna get caught. If I'm not careful. Which is what happens.
Ah.
taking smoke grenades. Yes. Now then, with that out of the way, we're gonna pull out a gun and we're essentially gonna go to town. It's the only way forward is to essentially just pulverize everybody. One guy's unconscious, so that is something that I've considered with him. One guy that I did not have to kill. So I was trying to get down from there, but I mean, there's like a ladder there that we can use probably to gain an edge on these on this battle. But yeah, I could not exactly find a way to get down to right up to the boot. I suppose the developers wanted to add a secondary route that we could use, but I could not for the life of me find anything. And turns out Fisher can't swim, because as soon as he gets near the water, he just dies. So. Yeah, sort of strange if you ask me, but that Navy SEAL dying when he gets near the water, or gets into the water, but I suppose it is what it is, so that's just how this level was designed, and look at that, look of freedom. Anyway, time to move down this ladder, and end this level then. Boy, that's bright. That mission complete theme, this mission complete theme in this game always reminds me of Unreal Tournament and you know, the introduction sequence to the original 2000s Unreal Tournament. That was bomb, to be honest. Komodo Shipyard, Komodo, Indonesia. April 18th, 2006, 6:32 hours. Mission complete. From the submarine relay, Sadono's call was traced to 5 satellite phone subscribers, each linked to the private military corporation. Armed Guardian Services. Okay, but during the briefing they said displays, were they about to use this plotline, the same plotline for Chaos Theory here? I wonder, because even the encrypted message that we picked up said displays, so yeah, Armed Guardian Services, Shadner teams will neutralize the box boxes. Virus armed NT-133. Freeing Third Echelon to neutralize Suhadi Sadono. Sahudi, I've been calling him Sahudi all this time. I wonder what that means, if it's like an Indonesian name, Sahudi. But Suhadi Sadono. That's the name we have to look for. And Armed Guardian Services. Now that sort of, maybe they just changed the story but forgot to change the text files and the in-game briefing details, but I'm glad that they did, because otherwise Chaos Theory would not have been the legendary masterstroke that it is. And so that's for this level. The next time we come around, we will probably be taking out Suhadi Sadono, right, I got it right this time. And that would probably be the end of Pandora Tomorrow, unless there is an extra level at the end of Los Angeles International Airport. Or if it was that way we took Sadono down, I don't recall at this point. But yeah, it is a pretty short level all in all, Pandora Tomorrow, that is. I think only 9 levels in total, but pretty long levels, each and every single one of them. And this game has been a blast to play. Even, I mean, the longer you play, the deeper that you get into the game, the more fun it becomes. The initial levels were a little more too many set pieces, and the stealth wasn't that immersive. And I also like the soundtrack that is playing in the background right now. But anyway, that's it for this level. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, wherein we kill Suhadi Sadono, apparently. Take care. Farewell, fellow things.